كيف تكون البراءة من الشرك وأهله؟
So how should a person dissociate himself from shirk and the people of shirk? How is this dissociation? How should it be?
من يعرف كيف نبرأ من الشرك وأهله؟ كيف تبرأ من الشرك وأهله؟
How do you free yourself from shirk and its people? Who knows?
تبرأ من الشرك وأهله بأمور ثلاثة.
You free yourself or dissociate yourself from a shirk and the people of shirk in three ways or through three matters.
بالقلب.
Number one, in your heart.
وباللسان.
Number two, upon your tongue.
وبالجوارح.
And number three, upon your limbs.
بالقلب واللسان والجوارح.
Through in your heart and upon your tongue and among upon your limbs.
البراءة من الشرك وأهله تكون بالقلب واللسان والجوارح.
Dissociating and freeing yourself from a shirk and the people of shirk is done through one's heart, tongue, and limbs.
بالقلب.
Upon the heart.
تبغض الكفار وعيادهم واحتفالاتهم وطقوسهم والشركيات والبدع.
Number one, you hate the disbelievers. You hate the gatherings, the celebrations, the festivals that are specific to them.
باللسان إنني براء مما تعبدون.
Upon your tongue, إنني براء مما تعبدون. I am free. I disassociate myself from that which you worship. Upon your tongue.
ولا أنتم عابدون ما أعبد ولا أنا عابد ما عبدتم.
And I do not worship that which you worship, and neither do you worship which I worship. Upon your tongue.
بالجوارح.
And also in terms of actions upon your limbs.
عدم مخالطة الكفار في أعيادهم واحتفالاتهم وطقوسهم.
And that is by not partaking with the disbelievers in terms of their festivals and celebrations and things which are specific to them.
أو يلبس لباس الكفار.
Or wearing the clothing of the disbelievers.
أو القصات. قصات الشعر.
Or how the haircuts or the ways that they cut their hair.
أو ينظر إليهم نظرة إعجاب.
Or even looking at the disbelievers and being amazed by them.
كالنظر للمصارع الحرة.
Like look.
مصارع. مصارع.
Like watching wrestling.
أو أفلام الغربية.
Or even Western films.
أو كأس العالم.
Or watching the World Cup.
نعم. الكافر عدو لمن؟
نعم, the kafir, the disbeliever, he is an enemy to whom?
من يعرف؟ الكافر عدو لمن؟ ما حد يتكلم. نعم. عدو لله فتح الله عليه.
The kafir, the disbeliever, is an enemy to Allah.
كيف يكون عدو لله وأنت تنظر إليه نظرة إعجاب؟
So how can this person, this disbeliever, be an enemy to Allah? And yet you look at this person, you're amazed by him and his actions.
لكن لابد أن نفرق بين الدعوة إلى الله وبين الإعجاب بالكافر والولاء والبراء.
But we have to differentiate between when we're calling to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala and when we're freeing ourselves from the disbelievers in terms of being amazed at their actions.
فمن حيث البراءة من الشرك وأهله لابد أن تبرأ من الشرك وأهله.
So in terms of freeing yourself from shirk and the people of shirk, this is an obligation upon you. You have to free yourself from them.
لكن هل معنى هذا أن تضرب الكافر؟
But does this mean that you start hitting the disbeliever?
تتعدى عليه؟
Or you take away his rights and oppress him?
لا, هذا باب التعامل أمر وباب البراءة من الشرك وأهله أمر آخر.
So these are two different separate things. One thing is interacting with the disbelievers, باب التعامل, how we interact with them. And the other separate thing is in terms of freeing yourself from their actions, the shirk and the people of shirk.
مثال.
So an example of this is.
هناك رجل والده نسأل الله السلامة عافية كافر.
So there's a person, a Muslim, and his father, we ask Allah for safety and pardon, he is a kafir, a disbeliever.
كيف يسمع مع هذا الأب؟
So now how does this Muslim child, what should he do, or how does he react with and interact with his non-Muslim father?
يحب محبة طبيعية من باب محبة الوالد.
So now this Muslim child is for him to love his father with a natural form of love, just like any child loves his father.
نعم. ويبغض في الله لأنه كافر.
But at the same time he hates him for the sake of Allah because he's a disbeliever.
يعني يجتمع في حب طبيعي وبغض في الله.
So at the same time this Muslim child he has within him love which is natural between a son and his father, and at the same time hatred for the sake of Allah.